Hi guys, welcome back. In this video I'll be showing you how to go from cold and dark to ready for takeoff in the Airbus A320 in FlightGear. Let's get started. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you are either going to connect the batteries and or you can go to utilities, ground services, and enable external power box, and then turn it on here. You can do either one of those, it'll work. Just for the sake of the video, I'll show you how to do the batteries one, but from that point onwards, it's the same. So you turn the batteries on using this button. So when you first get in, the plane will be like this. You turn them on with these, then we turn on the APU by pushing master switch and start. Then we're just going to wait until this says avail on the start switch. When it says avail, it goes green, say avail. That's when the APU's started and we're ready to, we're ready to connect it to the power bus. I think it should connect itself. So now the APU is running and you'll see everything's going to start to light up. If it doesn't start to light up, then you see this thing saying APU Gen. Try clicking on that to connect, just because normally it connects automatically, but if it doesn't connect automatically, then try clicking APU Gen to connect it manually. So while we're waiting for that to complete, we are going to basically, except for this, turn all of these switches that say off on, like that. And so now you can see our displays have all lit up and everything's connected. You can toggle this display down here, your main display, with these buttons. So you can see our maps aren't looking all that helpful, so we're going to need to turn on ADIRSs. We're going to have to turn those on. So just move these dials to nav. And this will take a while. I've seen it take up to like 10 minutes. So obviously I'm not going to make you watch through 10 minutes of this loading up. So I'm just going to, what I am going to show you though, is if you're in the dark, even if you're not in the dark, I recommend turning the lights on because it just makes it so much easier to see inside of the cockpit. And also, we can turn the lights on in the center pedestal. So now we've got all our lights on, which makes it a bit easy. You can see everything's coming up now. This display here, I've seen it take like up to like 10 minutes. Obviously, I'm not going to make you wait for 10 minutes. I'm going to cut the video until this comes up. Okay, guys, so we're back. I will put how long that took in post, but the our heading map here has appeared. So we're now ready for pushback and engine start. So for pushback, we are going to utilities, pushback, route, and then we can make a route the plane has to follow. So once we've got our route, we're going to connect the pushback and we're going to release the parking brakes with shift and B, and then done and push back. Okay, so now that we've finished pushing back, we're going to set the parking brake with shift and B again. We're going to disconnect the pushback. We can just close that window and go back to the cockpit. So we're now going to have to start the engines. So to start the engines, we're going to have to do turn APU bleed on. Then we're going to turn this little switch here to ignition start and set turn on these main switches, and now we're just going to wait for the engines to start. If the N2 value doesn't start going up, check that APU bleed is on. You need the APU bleed to be able to start the engines. Starting the engine should take maybe like 30 seconds or so. So once it's done, we can put the switch back to normal. And then we can taxi. So I'm just gonna speed up the video while we taxi to the back to the runway. Okay, so we're now lined up on the runway, ready for takeoff. So before we take off, I'm going to set basic autopilot settings and get our ejected takeoff stuff dialed in. Okay, so all that autopilot stuff is dialed in. So we're gonna set auto brake max there. We're gonna arm the speed brake, by clicking on it, you'll see it will rise up, the speed brake is armed. We're gonna set our flaps. We're also gonna open our FMC. And performance, and then these speeds work for me. V1 of 110, V2 of 135, and no, VR of 135, and a V2 of 152. Those just work for me. I'm not sure if they're the best, they just work from my experiments. So feel free to do your own research. Now, you can see we've got our eCam display. So basically it just wants us to do that. So now we can push F to set our engines to toga thrust. Oh, remember to turn the parking brake off, then push F. them to use the rudder by pushing 0 and enter on the numpad with number lock on, to because that also controls your nose wheel as well as your rudder. But remember to set it back to center when you are obviously about to take off. So we're now gonna rotate, and we're gonna do gear up just by pushing G. And when we get to 1,000 feet, or around 500 actually, we're going to push shift and F to set climb thrust. And we can also engage our autopilot and set our vertical speed here. So you'll notice now that our this mode has changed the speed, which means our engine's thrust are following this speed in knots. So yeah, that'll be it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.